ओके हेलो गाइस, टुडे इज द पॉडकास्ट विद दिनेश ओ बनेगा, सीईओ एट ओपन सिक्योरिटी अलायंस. सो टुडे ही विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट हाउ ही स्टार्टेड हिज जर्नी टू साइबर सिक्योरिटी. सो व्हाट प्रॉब्लम ही हैव फेस्ड इन द अर्ली स्टेजेस इनटू दिस इंडस्ट्री. ओके सो व्हाई टू डू लेट, सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद सर नाउ. यस सर, welcome to our podcast.
Thank you.
Coffee with hackers.
Yeah,
okay. Yes, sir. Before going into your journey, so can you say about yourself currently, what you are doing and all?
So currently, I am working in providing consulting and advisory services, primarily doing audit services, compliance services in RBI compliance, ISO compliance, business continuity, this sort of areas. And it started when I think about 15, 20 years now. I've been doing this work. And interesting journey.
Cool.
Because every day there are new laws which are coming out and new requirements. In addition to the fact that, of course, every day there are new technologies coming out.
Yeah, yeah.
And every technology which comes out, it brings good and bad at the same time.
Clear. Right?
So as we always say that technology is a sword, it is a knife. Right? So you can use a knife to kill somebody. Or you can use a knife to cut vegetables also, right?
So correct, sir. So like as you said, like new technologies are coming. And is that really new technologies will be coming, like AI nowadays? We are listening about AI, machine learning, big data science, a lot of things you are listening. Is that if these are coming, it's like the growth will be more and all. So is there a problem with our age people who are getting into this job and all? We will be facing a problems in future?
See, right now, the way I see it is that the people of your age and people who are coming in, they have a bigger problem in hand. They have a bigger problem because there are people who are, you know, previous generation, who have got good technology challenges also. They have old ideas or whatever. And they are still there in the system. And we have the new generation that are coming, like yourself and all. So you know that this is what needs to be done, and that guy says no. And you have to follow what he's saying, and you have to follow also technology. So that does create a big problem, as I have seen. And because there is the mismatch of ideas, the mismatch of thoughts which is there. Like they say, old generation, new generation. So people who are in management, people who are the elders, they must change and understand what the younger generation wants to do and how they are doing that. So that things become clearer. And whatever the risk of having a mismatch of ideas, that is reduced.
Okay, sir. So we get to know like currently what you are doing and all. Actually, we are knowing for each other from past 5 years. You remember like we have met in Tamil Nadu in one of the event BreakSec.
Yeah.
Okay. So around like March 13, I think today's date 27. So it's around like 5 years. After 5 years, we met. Okay. And you are my, from starting onwards in this journey, cybersecurity journey, you are my one of the motivations. So whatever the steps I take, you know that. Okay. Nothing to hide. I will talk with you personally. We are connected with phone calls. But after 5 years, again, we met. Okay. So I'm really very much curious about your journey, how you started. Like from your childhood, like your educations. I just want to know, how your family, how you grown up.
And family, of course, mine has moved from one city to another, even though we are in business. And
your dad was doing business.
We are all in business, that's not daily. Went into good times, bad times, hard times, and it evolved to a point where we came to Bombay. Like,
schooling time you came to?
No, school, I was in Delhi and Calcutta and Meerut.
Okay.
In UP and college.
How was your school time like?
School time was fun.
Yeah, how you were in studies and all?
I was supposed to be good in studies.
Okay.
So you understand things and yes, you do okay. And then you lose interest in studies. And which I always tell a lot of young friends like yourself who meet me, that you should not stop studying.
Mm-hmm.
People are very impressed by the fact that Bill Gates and all these guys, they were all dropouts.
Yeah, nowadays, like how Mark Zuckerberg did drop out, okay?
Everybody.
So this became a fashion nowadays.
Yeah. So I always tell people that you should not drop out. You should have fun. So I dropped out of college and I know what I missed over there. So, but that is the only time when you can really have fun, enjoy yourself, make good friends also. That is, those friends last with you for a lifetime. My friends from school and college, from that is now how many years? 72 I passed out of school.
Okay, 72.
72.
Plus two.
I didn't do 10 plus 2, that was good. 10 plus 2 was not there.
I did my IIC.
IIC was 11 years at that time. So, from 1972 to now, how many years? Friends are still in 50 years. Then my college finished, I think, in 78 or so. Those friends are still around.
Okay.
They are married, their children are got married, my children got married. We are all still friends.
Okay.
So those are the friends which will be there with you always. And then, and that is what you will miss out. The fun you will miss out, and those friends, those lifelong bonds you will miss out.
Mm.
They may not be with you in the same profession, but it is like that. And then also people feel that I am doing this and or somebody has advised me to do this and somebody has advised me to do that. It doesn't work.
But as school time means distractions, friends, different environment.
So these things, see, it's a growing period. It's a growing period. You can't stop situations around you from, you know, influencing you. You learn something. Be careful in what you're doing, and your parents are your guides. Those friends are not your guides. Because everybody has different, I would say, karma.
Why I'm asking this thing, because this podcast can be seen by that age group also,
yeah.
School children also. They will get to know about these things.
No, that's right. See, the thing is to always fall back on what your parents and what your teachers are teaching you. So don't try to think that you're damn smart. You're not. You may be the topper, you may be the best guy in sports, you may be the best guy with the best girls over there, or the best guys over there. You may be the best dancer, you may be the best, music player or sportsman or whatever. Your father and mother, your parents are the richest people in the country. And all this thing doesn't make a difference. So, even in today's day and age, if you read about the richest man in the country, his son, there was a news article about how he was being teased in school because he didn't have enough pocket money. So, it's a very different world. You go by that, see what your parents are telling you, see what your teachers are telling you. Go by that. Don't try to think that I know everything or my friend told me. No, it doesn't work.
Okay. So,
and when you're in college, maybe somebody got, placement for 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 30 lakhs. So, don't think that you will also get it.
Mm-hmm.
You will get what you will get. Okay, so don't try and think that yes, because I'm not getting 20, 30 likes, I'm not going to go. Maybe you'll then eventually end up having nothing else.
Okay.
Just go with the flow. Things will change as you get into your job or wherever you are. Things will change. I'll give you my journey. For example, my first job was selling pipes, plastic pipes and this thing. I should travel in the country. Small villages and towns going and selling pipes over there.
Okay.
Stop that, started selling books.
Oh, cool.
Stop that, started my own business. Doing exports. Used to export handicrafts, used to export things like that.
That college time?
No, after college. I dropped out of college also. So.
Huh?
I also dropped out of college.
Dropped out?
Cool.
So, lot of students will be having a doubts like getting into, because Dinesh Obalita is a cyber security expert. Okay, so rather than asking with others, why not we'll ask with him? Like after 10th, what field we have to go with? Some people will be having arts, commerce, science. In the science, again, bio, max, or like some people will be like thinking about MBBS or like a lot of things are there. But some students are there who will go with MBBS. Again, they are interested in cybersecurity.
So it doesn't matter what you do.
So I just want to ask with you, what type of field we have to take after 10?
Nothing like that. It is your interest. What are you interested in? I don't think it is necessary to become a doctor. It was at one time when I was growing up, you had to become a doctor or you have to be an engineer. Or you have to become IAS or IFS so that you can get good knowledge.
Okay.
Now things have changed. Parents and you, parents also understand, even though there are still many parents who still don't understand that if my child is not an engineer or not going into medical school or engineering school, he'll be a failure or whatever. No, it doesn't matter. Everybody is making good money.
You what you say, like after 10, any field,
everybody is making good money. Everybody makes money. You, and why should money be your goal? Money will come.
No, why they get confused like what science or arts? People are getting confused. They will ask with many people.
The moment you start asking, you're digging a hole. Everybody has got a different opinion.
Yeah.
Everybody has a different life. Today, you and me have the same business, same profession.
Yes.
But you are looking at a different time and differently.
Correct.
So if somebody asks me, I will say A, B, C. You will say X, Y, Z. Now what does that person understand? Because he doesn't know. Should he go by A, B, C or should he go by X, Y, Z?
That makes confusion.
No, because now what has happened is that he or she is dependent on a man. This guy has got so many other experience. He knows everything. He doesn't know everything. He knows nothing. Go and work hard. Study these subjects, see what interests you, and follow that. Don't try to think you'll become an Einstein on day one.
Correct.
Don't think you'll be Archimedes that you will do, you will discover on day one. You're not a Newton who's going to get an apple falling from the head. No chance. Those apples are all fallen, finished. There are no more apples to fall. Now, what is there? The tree is there, apple tree is there. To reach there, you have to work hard. Newton can just walk there and fly and lie down and sleep. Today, you go and try lying down and sleep under the tree, your father will come and slap you. Everybody in the come on. Wasting your time sitting under a tree. Go and do some work. So that time has gone. So now it is, you have to work hard. You have to trust your own intelligence.
Okay. Schooling is done now. So now the thing is college life. So we'll get into the college life of Dinesh sir, how it was, how you get into college, what department you have gone to.
No, I was basically in science, wanted to do my BSc, and you finished the BSc and dropped out.
BSc in
physics
and mathematics. Okay.
So I didn't do that, I dropped out. And
which year you dropped out?
I forget it. Yeah. Maybe 74, 75.
Second year or first year of it?
No, see, that time it was no first year, second year.
Okay.
That time it was in Mumbai, it was inter, and then it was junior college. There was no junior college, there was first year science and then second year.
Okay.
BSc. So 2 years of BSc after that. So I dropped out. And
What makes you
drop out?
Because of business?
No, I was interested. I sort of lost interest.
Okay.
And I wanted to go and join an art college to learn fine art, to start painting and drawing. My father said, no, you have to do this and then do your engineering. I said, I don't want to do that. So we had a fight at home and I said, I'm not going. He said, come and sit in the office.
What your dad business he was running?
Exports business.
So he said to come to office.
He said, can come to the office. We come to the office. Started working on that business. So came on to professional life. And over the years, did that exports work. Exporting pickles, exporting handicrafts, exporting newspaper.
Okay, so that makes the journey of exporting.
That started the journey. And then he expired and then I joined a firm, we are selling pipes and plastic.
Yes, as you said, expired. But that type will be hard, na, for you. how you overcome that thing. Because a lot of students, because of this situation, it's like it is a situation with every.
What can you do?
Yeah. How you can overcome?
No, what can you do?
People go into depression also.
No, he's gone. You go into depression now. People have gone into depression. People will go into depression. My question to that person going into depression or thinking, my father is gone. Can he come back?
No.
He won't come back. Finished. Now you have to go on with life. You got two choices. One is just to stand up, or the second is to lie down over there and keep crying. Cry and screw up your life also. And not just your life, screw up the life of everybody around you. The day it happened, sat down and I said, now what are the options?
Sibling was there?
Sorry?
Your sibling?
Yeah, sibling was. So it was, what are the options? Options are this. This is father's business. This is the work which you are doing. What do you want to do? So, some millennials of mine said, do this. So, okay, we went and did that. Today when I look back and I said, did I do the right thing? Why should you think whether you did the right thing or not? So if I think back, 50 years or 40 years and say, hey, no, it was the wrong thing. So it doesn't make any difference. The wrong thing you did 40 years back, what can you do now? Or even if you think about wrong thing 10 years later, you can't.
So we get into the college life. Okay, so how he get into business in that early age? Okay, I think that's the reason you are suggesting us the newcomers into this industry, like, or any students, like, don't drop out. Why? What's the reason?
See, dropping out means you're losing one part of your life. That part of the life when you can think, you can ideate, you can innovate. You have hundreds of other students and you have teachers and professors and all that around you.
Okay. You're staying with your own experience.
You can have fun. When you start doing business, you can't have fun actually, like, you know. So it's not possible because you're working, your work calls you. College or school, you can take 7 days off and go to a hill station and with fun with friends. Try it once you start joining if you joined a company as an employee or if you're doing your own business.
Cannot do that. So that's the reason, like, with your experience, you're saying that. No,
that is the time of life when you know these experiences all help you to build up. Their experiences, their memories which will help you to build up, their bonding times which will help you to build up.
Okay, so but as you were saying,
not just about fun, it's about the experience also.
Okay. So, as he get into business, exporting and all, so after that, how you were like, went into this cybersecurity, you went into cybersecurity?
Oh, many years later.
Yeah. So, after that, what you were doing?
This is the exports and all, this is the year around 1980s.
Okay.
Then, things went wrong and we switched from there to making, what did we do? Leather goods.
Leather goods. Okay.
Started manufacturing leather goods. Because we exported some leather goods and then somebody else wanted us to supply them, so we started making for them. We started making and supplying leather goods. Then from leather goods we spread it to, I don't remember what, something good thing. And we came to the year 1984. So 1994 or so, My CA called me.
Okay.
Young fellow. My CA called me, Dinesh. It was around 7:38 in the evening that I bought a computer.
Okay.
I said, Reva, I want to come and see. Are you in the office? Yes, fine.
First time?
Yeah. So immediately I left from home. And
what age will be? 30,
40? Well, 94.
1994.
About 25 years back. So I go immediately to his place and he shows me a computer. He has a 286 with a CRT monitor. And he says, this is the computer. I said, wow, okay, good man, what can you do? So he starts a load of my and you said, see, put some numbers and you showed me how it multiplies.
Okay, right.
Blah, blah, so wow, and this.
Okay, this
I also want one.
Calculator is using this
thing.
I also want one.
Okay,
bro. And then he showed me a word processor, how you can type over there and then print out and just drop notice and touch. So, fuck, I also want to buy one. How much does it cost? It's 50,000 rupees. 50 or 60,000.
Oh, that cost me that
time. So, it's okay. I also want to buy. When I asked him one thing, I said, how do you do business in this? I asked him. He said, I don't know. He said, what you can use it for? Lotus and... I know that you can do business with computers. So I'm an exporter.
Okay.
Basically. So I don't know then, okay.
It is that was the first time seeing computer?
Yeah, first time.
1994.
Mm. So, he introduces me to a supplier and that guy is surprising me in a pusher and he brings it and installs it in my office. And I again ask him, I said, how do I do business with this? He says, I don't know.
Mm.
I said, okay, then tell me how do you. I said, I know one thing that you can use this computer to connect with others. I don't know. So he gives me a computer and he goes away. Now I'm a non technical guy.
Okay.
The first time in my life I've seen a computer and I buy one for $50,000. And now I want to know that how do I going to use it for business? Nobody knows. And I want to know how do I connect it. So I know that you can use a computer to connect to other computers in the world. And nobody knows that also. Because I know only my C and I know this supply. So I go into the market and I ask them, I said, computer connect, how do you connect? Nobody knows. Maybe I'm not speaking the same language. So I go and buy some books and magazines and all that. And I start reading. I come across one word, modem. Oh. So now I go to the market again, modem. I want a modem.
Okay, point then.
Very good. So somebody sells me a modem for about 7.5 MBPS or something like that. So, okay. Now I bring a modem home, open the box.
How do you
connect to the computer? So there are wires I can at least understand. This is telecom wire and this is where it goes. Okay, fine, telecom. That is normal. Telephone like that. Now you know that you have a computer, you have a modem, connected to the telephone line. Correct?
Mm.
Now what do you do? Your system is connected to the computer, to the internet. For example, if it's on your laptop, it's connected to the internet. You don't have a password, so you don't know where to put the password. People have that problem, right?
Mm.
Your password, supposing you put the password also.
Okay.
Now it is connected to the internet. How do you connect to the internet?
That was the
number. I don't have a browser. What do you do in today's day and age? Now I'm talking about 20 years back, 25 years back.
Mm.
I have a modem, it is connected to my computer. My modem is connected to my phone line.
Mm.
And just sitting up there like this, and I'm looking at how do I do? I don't know what to do. The magazine is telling me that there has to be a dialer. Now, where do I get a dialer from? I don't know.
That time, there was no YouTube also to see the tutorials.
There was no YouTube, there was no live, there was no Yahoo, there was nothing. So, it tells me, connect the dialer. Where is the dialer? Then another article tells me that there is something called a PBS. Very good. Bulletin board service.
Okay.
Fair enough. Bulletin board service. Now fine. And it also has the instruction how to get a dialer and how to connect to the grid. Very good. So I follow that. And I get a dialer and I dial out. Another article, PC Quest and all these magazines is what I'm reading.
Okay.
And I'm learning. So now it gives me the instructions of getting connected to the PBS. A bulletin board service. Now, you guys wouldn't even know what a bulletin board service is. So, you have to look at them and see what it is. So, I get that. And now I'm going to dial out. The first time in my life, I hear the screech. It's called a banshee sound of a modem.
Like
that. So, it's a modem connection sound.
Ah, yeah.
Okay. It's a screech. So that is the sound I hear, and my screech says connected to says live IMBBS. It is the most happiest moment of my life that my computer has connected somewhere else. Now, where that is, I don't know. But it's connected to somebody somewhere else, and it has worked.
Mm.
Okay. It has taken me about 1 month or more to sort of come there.
Mm.
After that, it is. See, people don't read.
Mm.
Even in today's day and age, we just accept, accept, accept.
Mm.
And run. So, and then we get confused. So, what to do, what not to do? You have to start reading.
Mm.
Even there, it was the same thing.
The modules that
it is manually
there.
It is a CRT monitor.
Mm.
So it's giving you a monochrome output. And it is telling you, know, press F1 for so and so, F2 for this, F3 for this, or 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. Enter the BBS, introduce yourself, this, that, or whatever. So I just follow that instruction and I reach inside the BBS and I'm in a what do you call it, a meeting room, and there are other guys over there. I can see their names.
Mm.
I can see their names.
Mm.
And somebody said, hi, my name was Dinesh. Hi, Dinesh. Oh, wow. So who are you? And this and that. So then it's a normal thing. You start talking. You understand. Mm. Okay. See, it's logical flow.
Mm.
Computers talk to you logically. This is not irrational, like somebody, a computer just says anything. It's not a human being. Which is, human being can do that. Now, I'm talking to you about computers just now, and all of a sudden I just come and talk to you, so I'm talking to you about cottage or about some accident which happened over here. That is, we can be illogical in that manner. But a computer is talking to you about something, and keep on talking to you about that.
Mm-hmm.
The same manner, this is what's happening. And people forget that. Now, I'm a total novice. I'm seeing a computer for the first time, then I'm struggling to find a way to do something. My intelligence of my reading, my knowledge has told me for the last so many years that computers, you can do business.
Mm.
Nobody knows. I come into the BBS, I come into a meeting room. The first question I asked was, how do you use this for your business? So somebody said, bugger off, you don't do business, this is over here. You know how to do programming. I said, what is that? Okay.
So at the assembly language at all was there.
I don't care. Even today I don't care.
Mm.
My mother has told me so many times, hundreds of times, you should go and learn programming, go into this. I said, no, mama, there is somebody else who will do that for me. I don't want to do this.
Actually, that early stage was a real struggle to get into the technology.
Yeah. So people were getting into it, so people were there who knew all that.
Mm.
Now, 1 month or 2 months it has taken me to reach there. Then it takes me another couple of months to understand there's something called email.
Mm-hmm.
Or there's something called messaging. This is what messaging I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
And BBS is what? BBS is 5 or 6 computers or more computers, which is run by somebody who has a hobby.
Mm-hmm.
So he has a program that is running and people are connecting him outside. He is able to invest that money and allow people to connect. And it's free of cost.
Mm-hmm.
And they would... His machines would store data, so he won't do anything like that. His machines allow him to connect to what we call deep web today.
Hmm.
See, deep web is not pornography or what do you call it, crime computer.
Crime thing, yeah. People talk about nowadays.
No, there is a lot of knowledge over there.
Hmm.
All the internet, academia files, the DOD files, this and that, whatever was available was at that time. I remember there were commands like Gopher, G-O-P-H-E-R.
Yeah,
okay. You can still use those commands, or you still need to use those commands to basically pull data from these databases. So the academia databases.
Yeah.
So today, the internet is about 15-20 years old, but that time also there was this Harvard and all these institutes, they had all put their data completely over there. So that is all available. It is still available today. People do research over there. And for us, we couldn't get information by sending commands. So I will say Dinesh at BBS something, and I will send a command.
Mm-hmm.
So it will go by email. Which I didn't know it was going by email or what. I just know you, okay, yeah, this is how you send it.
Mm.
So I send the command. If after one day I get a thing, no information available, try XYZ or try help. So then I'll send a help or a dash H and something more as per the instruction is given. Again, it's not active. Maybe send me some information. I'm trying to ask how to do business. But it goes on and on and on. And then I said, yeah, this is no.
That time it was a deep web, correct? Nowadays people are using
search. You're calling it deep web now. There was no Google.
But now people say.
Google was not there.
Yeah.
There was no Yahoo. I'm talking about time when there was no Yahoo. It was not yet made. 93, 94, there was no Yahoo. There was no Google.
Correct.
There was only DOS. Only DOS was there. Then Windows NT came later on.
DOS is it's a one type of BIOS, we can say, na? Like
no, DOS is OS.
DOS is OS, but whenever we are taking a system without operating system, it will be DOS only. In that, they will install the OS. Correct.
So DOS is Microsoft. And that time there was a time of Sun and IBM, AX, and all that.
Yeah, IBM.
Yeah. But for a PC user, that's what it was. Or you had to go and buy a Mac. And that was a different thing altogether. Who understood Mac? There were different type of people, like Shamit Guru and all who had Mac. Okay, so, and then you sort of came to know that there's a company which is offering email services, and then, so we can move faster. Okay, so you went to Sprint. Sprint was the email service company, EMS, Sprint EMS. We went to Sprint, and Sprint says 25 or 30,000 rupees for your email address. So now I can't afford that. And so on the BBS in the group, five of us got together, and we took the email address. So because it allowed us four or five different names, and so we chose the name and we started using that. It ran for a few years, and then VSNL came.
Yes.
VSNL started services in 1995. So, I took an account in VSNL. I was account number 72. The 72nd account they gave on VSNL. So, and by that time, somebody said that, do you know there's something called WWW World Wide Web? This is all discussions happening on the BBS, right? So that's where you learn. Or you are the magazines which are reading World Wide Web. So somebody shows a picture in the magazine. And you wonder, So let's wait till you come. VSNL started internet. Text service. So there was no graphics. There were graphics, I'm not too sure. I don't remember. But I subscribed to the text service, it was 5,000 rupees, and the other one I think was 10 or 15 dollars, 20 dollars. So that was the internet and email or whatever. So you could read your email and browse.
That time, as you said, like no Google, no Yahoo, Bing, nothing was there. So whatever the context was coming in internet, it will be open for everyone, right? No filtering, nothing. The data.
No filtering again, that concept was not there. See, the concept of the internet though, it is about sharing data, sharing information.
Okay.
And getting to know people and networking. See, you know, over the years, things have changed, right? You know, so, it's like that. And lots of, I would say, crime has come up. And
yeah.
And all. So, these things have to come up. And I was doing. I started email services. I took domain names. I bought to call domain names. I still have one old domain from some 74, 75.
Okay.
It is still there with me. So that's when I take that domain name. And because nobody had domain names, I could have bought Tata.com. I could have bought IndraGandhi.com. I could have bought any domain.
Ah.
I know all available.
Okay.
Tata domain was purchased by somebody, by the way.
Uh-huh.
If you look at the history, somebody had purchased Tata.com and they'll later on Tata file a case against them and got the domain back.
Actually, that is a good suggestion for businesses. If they are running a huge company or something, if you not still have the domain, kindly go and search, buy your domain, correct?
They should buy a domain. They should buy similar something domain as well.
Mm.
Not just one domain.
Or else they can face a
huge. They should buy 100 above and 100 below.
Okay. Different type.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So if you have TATA and I present TATAA, then.
So there are the phishing problems and phishing attacks.
Yeah. And that time in 94, 95, nobody even had a website.
Mm.
There was a company I knew in 94. They set up the very first Indian website.
Okay.
So I went to his, of course, I came up to the India, so we came to know this guy. So I called him and I said, I wanted to say, oh, come. Nobody had any problem.
Mm.
Today, you have a first thing appointment here, so why do you want to come? Just that. A guy called him and I am Dinesh and I want to see you. He said, hey, come over here, come on. No problem. So we went there and, of course, his father is a rich man. And this guy had studied in the US and just come back. So he had a website and his partners were in America. He had
which
a.
Year was
90.
This
was 94. 94. He had a CRE monitor, color CRE monitor.
Okay.
This big. And, he's about your height. Let's short term. He's sitting on his chair and he's looking at that, wearing big glasses and doing the. He's a Linuxer basically. And
Linuxer
and brilliant guy. So I go, what do you do? What is this? The thing is, it turns the monitor like this. I'm sitting in front of him. And I see, again, the first time in my life, I see a color monitor. This big, showing me his website. I say, yeah, awesome man. Tell you what you do. What is that? His site is all news. So what he has got is he has put 30, 40 girls and boys who are doing typing work. Yet they and he's getting newspapers from all over the country. His father and mother and daughter, five, they cut the articles and they give the articles to these people. They type those articles and these guys are taking the articles and putting it online. Now, what he would do is he would upload the complete text file in the evening. After 6 o'clock, that is the time when you get half rate on international calls.
Okay.
So he was connected because he also has to use a modem. Mm. My modem was 7.5, his modem is 28.8. So he is 3 generations ahead of me in any case. And 28.8 kbps. Not mbps.
Wow.
Okay. I am still at 2.8. When I went and bought the next one.
2.8 kbps.
Yes.
Oh.
So when I went and bought my next modem, after sometimes I started realizing 5-600 years and he threw a better car.
Same problem when I was in Andaman. Actually, I'm from Andaman, Nicobar Island. So there was like before COVID, there was no good internet. So the same problem like 10 kbps. Like I'm saying about 5-6 years like back. You know that, huh? So no, I think you also visited Andaman,
no.
So the 10 kb per second, 5-6 years. That time I think outside here it was like you can get nicely internet. But like 6 years back something like 10 kb per second, 50 kb per second. But if you're going with the Wi-Fi something model, you can get 300 kb per second or 500 kb per second. That was, I can understand the pain, how it will be loading. So
that is, this is not a pain. This is the only life you know.
Okay, you don't know about.
No, this is science fiction.
Mm.
In those days, this is science fiction.
No, I can imagine.
So, this is the life you know. See, right now, what is the life we know? We know that, yes, this is 9 meters. Maybe 5 years from now, the building will be air conditioned. Then that is the normal.
No, I can able to connect. Why? Because when I was coming Chennai somewhere. I like with my family for trip and all. I was opening my phone. I can able to access internet in a second.
Correct.
But when it's in Andaman, I was like for opening the screen, Google search engine only, exactly. It was taking around 2-3 minutes.
Yeah.
I can connect with you that time how slow the internet was.
Yeah. So I went to this guy and my question to him again was the same thing. How do you do business? How can I do business over here like this? So I don't know. So yeah, you're doing this and you're connecting with people in America and all that, and you have your partner over there. He said, what do you do? I said, I do exports. What do you want to do? I said, okay, do business. Nobody seems to know. Just think about it. Then while you're thinking, I said, okay, tell you nothing. I've got these leather goods and these things. He started showing me emails and feedback from people who are seeing his website. I'm great saying thank you very much. I can come to know what India much better and all that. Because people who are living over there, who have gone to study and people who are living over there, for them the only way of knowing news in India was there are one or two newspapers in the US which are carrying Indian news.
Okay.
But that's weekly. Okay. And otherwise you call up home, but you can't call up home every day. It is expiring. Now the website has come up where he is getting news from all over the country and typing it and putting it out. So if you are subscribing, I said that subscription was free also.
Okay.
So if you are in the US and you check his website, you will come to know news, no? So it is good. And people are appreciating and people are saying thank you to him.
Okay.
Right? So somebody is saying thank you and somebody is saying you show me the news. I see, yeah, this is what I said, why not? Why can't they buy something from me? I'm telling that. He said, what do you mean? I said, see, you already have this showing over there. You put my products also. And
that's how you started.
So we put flowers, cakes, chocolates, and my leather goods. Four items.
Cool.
On his website.
Okay.
So he used to upload in the night after 6 o'clock for the half price. So now he has to upload text as well as pictures.
Okay.
So he'll pick the full web page over here and upload his friend, his partner will upload over there also. We need to discuss about payment. How will you get the payment? We said we'll charge the card over there. And then we'll give the money. Okay, fine. So today he put it up. I'm at home and my computer is on. 12:15 my first order comes. For flowers to be delivered in. We started only Bombay.
Okay. That time
1996. 94. And first order, flowers, $19.95. I go and buy the flowers for two or three rupees. And I go take a rickshaw and go and deliver. So for $20 I got, I think it was 60 rupees or 50 rupees a dollar. So it's still 1,000 rupees.
Huh?
I buy for 150 and I go and sell it for 1,000 rupees. I'm good.
Good.
By the time I come home in the evening afternoon, I already have 3-4 more orders. We did very good. And then we increased the service from Bombay to other cities. In the end, we were doing all India. And we were the only
plan.
I was the first business online.
Okay, on those times, which is the biggest internet company?
There was no internet company.
That time, no internet company. Like, who were running their business in online, the biggest company?
Rediff came later on. Then IndiaMart.
Yeah,
they were just dial. I heard just dial put their database. The first time they put their database was done by me.
Okay.
And then we had a fight and.
Why was the problem happen?
Money. So just dial.com was purchased by me for them.
Okay.
And then this guy also had a fight with his partner and all he broke away and I did it myself and. Then over a period of time, the online business sort of fell flat and We were doing, I started doing some website development and progressed into that.
Shaadi.com also was one of them.
Shaadi came along later on.
Okay.
Shaadi came, Yahoo came, Google came. So one by one, all of them came. Then I went up to the US to start internet work over there. So I went, I think about a couple of months later, many of them happened. Everything closed over there. I came back for 5-6 months or 10 months later. It's a progression. It takes time.
Okay.
Everything takes time. See, one to another.
Because 98, internet boom, 98.
Bust. Yeah. Internet bust. So everybody was getting onto the internet and then went flat.
Okay.
So that's when things went wrong for everybody. And when I was in the US, that's when I learned about something called cybersecurity.
Okay, in US.
That's something called computer security, not cybersecurity. Cyber came about 4-5 years back. It was computer security, internet, and information security. So I learned, I started reading about it. So see, my knowledge or whatever is based on whatever I have learned. When I tell everybody, read. And people think, people feel. My interns or people whom I know, they will read. But they will read, okay, 20-page book you have read. So they read. What did you read? What did you understand? Have you learned something from them? I learned something. That helped. Reading means not just reading. Reading means understanding, and what you don't understand, go to the net and then again find out and then again come back over there. Stop over there. Make your notes. Do this, do that. But no, so if you have read 100 books, doesn't make a difference. That 100 books, what have you absorbed from that 100? So I came up with one article. I came up with, I still remember sitting over there in my friend's office, and the New York Times, I'm waiting for it to come and meet me. So I opened New York Times, one small article, computer security, something. Is not being taken seriously or whatever. I said, what the hell is, what is computer security there? Small article, 1, 2, 3, 2 columns or something like that, small column. In that small column, it just said that people, computer security needs to be done, and these two, three things to be taken care of, and people are not doing it. And the first question, the first thought in my mind was, I said, why these idiots, why can't I do this? There's nothing big to do over here. You have to do your patch or the patch, but I don't remember what was there exactly. But very simple stuff.
Even that was the first time when you seen about computer security.
Yeah.
New technology.
Brand new stuff here. I've never heard about it in my life. And I say, people are idiots, why don't they? So simple. I say, yeah, Dinesh, let's forget everything. Because I was until then focusing on websites. And e-commerce, everybody's doing this yet. Nobody's doing this. So came back to India, tried to find a job, really find a job. So you don't know anything. No certification or nothing. So I started, I don't know what certification is required. So I started trying to hunt what certification is required for this.
Okay.
Education I can't do.
So
they don't expect you to do computer engineering or something like that. I can't go into that. A certification, but let me see. I found one certification, it was expensive, and I went. So I found the cheaper end. Did that. Again, went to find a job.
How you got the guidance?
Nobody will guide you. Nobody guided you. Read the internet. Read. Read books. Ask people. Go on the internet. Nobody told me. How to make a web page? Nobody told me.
Nowadays, if you
need
simple guidance, you
get
a lot.
Yeah, I still know only HTML / HTML closer tag. That's all. I can do that much. That's all.
Yeah.
But again, nobody told me. That's what I feel. That's why I tell people, there's nothing great over here, simple things to do. and follow. That's all. Like a sanitizer also. Simple things to do. You have to come at 10 o'clock, come at 10. Simple thing. What's the big deal about that?
If you read properly, you'll understand the concepts.
You read, what you don't understand, go and find out, ask somebody. People are reading, they don't understand, they still reading.
Now, if you're searching for guidance or learning something, a lot of resources, a lot of guidance, the people are there, but people not use totally using resources.
Okay, so that's how Dinesh sir get into computer security or information security, cyber security. Okay, so how you come into this cyber security business?
When I started, it was just computer security. And then over a period, then it became information security. Then after some time, people started talking about cyber security. So now we say that cyber security is something different and information security is something different. We don't talk about computer security as a... So you're doing cyber security earlier also as part of information security. Now you're doing, say, cyber security and information security.
What is the difference between cyber security and information security?
See, when we talk about cyber security, we are talking about everything. But actually, if you talk about theoretically, then it is cyber security is about whatever assets are facing the outside world. And information security is inside your infrastructure.
Okay.
That is information security. When you say theoretically. So by definition, by the law, by regulations, by best practices, that is what you say when you say cyber security. Information security. And cyber security is everything which faces outwards. So your web, web-based machines, applications, whatever is facing the cyber security.
So you started into this business, the compliance, giving a compliance services to the. So what was the first client into this business?
No,
how you acquired the first client?
I would say first business. I was working in a company as a project manager.
Okay.
At which time, because I didn't get a job. I tried to find a certificate. I found a certification, but BS 7789, I think. That is what ISO 27001 was at that time. It was BS 27001.
That
is now. Now it is ISO 27001. At that time, BS 7789.
Okay.
So I did that certification and I started waiting for a job again. I couldn't find a job. Nobody gave me a job. I got no experience. They said, you got no experience. I said, I can still do it. No problem. No. Okay, fine. I had to find a job. I found a job. Company as a project manager. I was doing that job. And because at the same time, I kept hunting for security things. Okay. I wanted to be there. So I kept hunting for security. I couldn't find. And then somebody said, no, you have to change your certificate.
It was interest or past and you got it into cyber.
No, I know this is the future.
Okay.
I know this is the place to be and this is all bullshit. So, and I have to get into it. How? So, okay, fine. So, now to get the better certification, what is the better certification? And somebody said, do CISA. So now I started going to find what is CISA. I found what, okay, this is CISA, fair enough. It could cost me $500, okay, fine. And I need this sort of experience or whatever, okay, fine. And okay, so I filled the exam form and I went to give the exam and I passed. I've never done an audit in my life. I still went to the exam and I passed, okay, fine. And I get certified. Then I told that company, which is a large company, I told them that you do need to do security. And the company management said, no, it's of no use. I said, okay, but whenever you will do, I should be given the charge. I said, okay. Then about 5-6 months later, they hired somebody for security and they didn't tell me. So I resigned and get out of it. In the meantime, there was somebody else looking. I got a job. My job was in Canada.
Okay.
So I moved to Canada. And that is where the first engagement was in a bank. The first engagement which I was put on was in a bank.
Bank.
Security audit and stuff like that. Now again, funnily, funny that I have never in my life done an audit. And my first job as a in a security role, and I go to a bank to do audit over there. So, from my experience, I keep telling people, I said, it is not rocket science, there is nothing complex over here. It is about reading the English and understanding what is required and being able to ask a question. So if you read the RBI guidelines, you read the SEBI guidelines, you read ISO, you read, they tell you to do this. The law says do this. Like the RTO law says, stop at the red signal. Now if you don't stop over there, what will happen? Either there will be an accident, or the cop will stop you and fine, charge a fine from you, or the cop will stop you and tell you get out and take your car away. That is what it is. It is simple. Now, I am not a lawyer. I don't need to be a lawyer to go and fight the case in court. Now, if I need to go and fight the case in court, then I need to be a lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, I am auditing. I am asking questions and trying to find out whether things are right or wrong. So, the guideline is there.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be the same to you.
Mm-hmm.
Over a period of time, you will understand networks.
Which bank it was?
So it was a credit bank. So over a period of time you'll understand, okay, when I'm talking about networking, these are the questions I should be asking. Or when I'm talking about policy, these are the things. Over a period of time you'll understand. But you have to read. If you're born in without preparation, you're bound to fail, you're bound to fall flat. If you think you're damn smart, you don't need to prepare, then you're a different thing altogether. And today there are young kids who think they're damn smart.
Mm-hmm.
See, you do a ethical hacking course
mm-hmm.
for 2 weeks,
mm-hmm.
15 days, you get a certificate, ISO, ISNS certificate, 3 days or 4 days.
Mm-hmm.
You are not an auditor after that. You have understood that this is a law, this is how it is done. Then apply your mind. But you think that because now you have a certificate,
mm-hmm.
you are God's gift to mankind, you are not.
And it's always our experience behind you.
You will have.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And experience, 1 year of experience means 365 days.
Mm.
I tell people, 365 days you can't crunch. You can't go and say that I've got 5 years of experience in 1 year's time.
Like,
it's impossible. After
1 year of the experience also, they will say that cybersecurity expert. It is not only about expert, it's all about learning. Passion about the subject.
People will
become, others have to say that he is the expert.
So people become experts even after going in one lecture.
Mm.
So that's another story. So it's but theek hai. So over a period of time, then this is where I am.
Mm.
Came back.
So after that, cyber security companies. I think you work in Microsoft as an.
No. I came back from Canada and I've just done my own business after that.
Okay.
Nobody gave me a job. See, the thing about cybersecurity or even IT,
mm.
what my experience has been that if, when you are in your 20s, it is easy for you to get jobs and to move.
Mm-hmm. 20s to 30s,
mm. you're okay.
Mm.
No, things move fast.
Mm.
You should settle in by the time you're 25 or end of 20s. You should start settling in. Don't start jumping at that time.
Mm.
In your 30s, stabilize yourself. Make good money, make sure that you get
married,
you get trans, you know, you get married, you grow, your salaries become better, then stop. If you want to move before you cross 30.
Okay.
So when you come to 34, 35, 36, your job prospects become smaller and smaller.
Mm-hmm.
By the time you're 40, people will not give you a job. Okay. So, the job market shrinks for you.
Mm.
A lot of people say that, hey, I want to hire somebody who has experience. But when you try to hire somebody who's in cybersecurity or in IT with at the age of 40 or 45, by that time, this guy has about 15, 20 years of experience.
Mm.
His salary is 6 or 7 figures. Nobody can afford that person.
Correct.
Okay, very difficult.
So, 5 years back, we have talked about one of the company. They have mentioned the India map in the wrong way. So you remember that incident?
Yeah.
So can you elaborate about that issue? Rather than disclosing the company name, you can just...
No, that was SANS.
Okay.
The first guy who did that was SANS. After that, many companies have done that. Tata has done that. Government of India, DRD has done that.
Mm-hmm.
Showing the map wrong way.
Is that correct thing what they are doing? Like not how correct. The government have taken the serious actions of that?
Nothing. Government doesn't do it.
Okay, so the next, I just want to ask that question one thing. What do you think, how serious is government about cyber security?
Government is serious, but just being serious is not enough. No?
Mm.
I'm very serious about getting married. I'm very serious about finding a girlfriend.
Mm.
Just being serious will help you. Like either today I talked to you, I'm very serious about doing 1, 2, 3 things in cyber security.
Okay.
Just being serious, so what?
Doesn't make matter.
You're serious, so what?
It has to be.
What have you done? Mm. What are you doing? Have you taken your first step, second step, third step? What are you doing? Where is your plan? You don't have a plan. You're serious about so many
things in life. Have you seen any process going on, how they're growing and all?
No, there's a lot of things happening.
Mm.
Lot of things are happening, and a lot of good things are happening, a lot of nothings are happening.
Mm.
So, it takes one time to evolve. Is it government?
I have listened that also like blockchain technology they can introduce in India.
What do you do with blockchain?
Like to keep the data be secure. It can be implemented in government sectors like how?
Who will put the money in? Blockchain.
It's not a good idea.
No. Where in the world do you find the application of blockchain at that level? Everybody is talking about blockchain. I want to see on the ground. Show me a large scale application of blockchain or interconnectivity.
Actually, one small idea like for myself, like implementing like how the money flows from government to the public sectors. So it have to be like disclosed to the publicly, we can know that how the money flows from one place to another.
Recently, Supreme Court told State Bank of India to give information on electoral bonds.
Mm.
Electoral bonds. I don't know whether you read about that.
Okay.
How much has SBI told them? Out of this much, they said they showed this much.
Okay.
Then Supreme Court again. Maro danda. Mm. Then they said this much.
Mm.
Then again they maro danda.
Mm.
Then this much.
So they are not ready to show how it flows, na?
There is so much happening.
Mm.
Why they did not show? What did they say? That we will take 3 months to get the information.
Okay.
You're a bank.
Mm.
In the morning when I give you money,
mm.
or money comes in 24/7, right? By the end of the day, that money reconciliation has already happened. Who has taken the money, where it has come from, who it has gone to. All the ledger, the balance. It is automatic.
Okay.
And if State Bank of India says, I can't find out that. So blockchain, what will happen in blockchain? Okay. How will you say transparency? Who will show it to whom?
They are not
like that. We are still, I would say, light years away.
Mm.
Is Dharmaraj.
Mm.
You understand Dharmaraj? Yudhishthir.
Okay,
huh. Right? Satyug is what? Satya.
Satya.
Yes.
Satch.
Dharam is total righteousness for everybody. We talk about equality. Mm-hmm. Where is the equality?
Okay. So, yeah, how cyber security can play a social role after the Digital India initiative taken by Mr. Narendra Modi ji?
The Digital India has brought a lot of, I would say, good stuff at rural levels also.
Okay.
For example, banking has reached there. The Manrega, the payments systems, payments are reaching them. There are middlemen and the other guys, the bad guys who are in between there for so many years.
Mm.
They are moving out. It takes a little more time for them to move out. But there's a lot of good stuff which has happened. Like you were talking about internet connectivity in Andaman.
Mm.
That was 5-10 years back. I'm sure now it is much different. Mm.
So, now it's good.
So things are changing and the benefits will of course reach. But at the same time, it'll take time.
Mm.
Digital Indian Initiative is huge. India is a very big country, very, very different.
As the Modi ji, it's a good initiative what he have taken. What's your
lots of good initiatives.
Mm.
I don't say that the initiatives are bad.
Mm.
I just say that how do they connect to each other?
As they are really executing properly?
I wouldn't know, frankly. What I read is what I know. I think that's what everybody knows. Unless you are in the system, and then you see it. But any initiative of that size, and see, we are a large country, yes. We are not as large as US or what. They are huge countries.
Okay, right.
But our diversity of environment is very different. The US is very organized and structured. So it's easier to do things in that manner over there. Our case, the structure is not there at the environmental or the basic level. That is where our challenge comes. Some places where there is no road, but people are there. Some places, you know, the benefits are to reach there. There are so many things which we have done in the country. So many things which are not done, but yes, there is still hope.
So, what will be the future in the cyber security?
I don't think anyone can tell me what will be the future. The future changes every day. Every day the future changes.
See, as in 30 years back, as you said 30 years back, you've seen that cyber security will be the future. That makes you to get into this domain.
No, that's right.
So now, question again.
No, no. See, cyber security is essential everywhere. You have become technology, completely technology. Right? So, you had a phone which is separate. You had a TV which is separate. You had a laptop which is separate. The different devices. Today, all click right, they are connected. But they have the same apps also. So, you have to take care of the configuration on all the four, five, six. That connected will become, they will merge. We are already reading about Neuralink. Have you heard about Neuralink?
Yeah,
like Elon Musk, right?
Yeah. So it can
implant the chip in the brain.
Chip into the brain and it can monitor the sensors.
Oh, that guy is using it. There's a disabled person.
They tried with pig, I think.
There's a disabled person who already started using and playing games.
Okay.
So that is the future coming up. Now, in that case, where will cybersecurity be? Or when we talk about the pacemakers and other devices, medical devices and stuff like that. So it has to be everywhere. The thing about cybersecurity is that it has to be embedded in whatever you are doing, which is not happening.
Okay.
So somebody has to come along with a brilliant mind or whatever and be able to push it in that manner. So where you can push cybersecurity at the design level itself into space, into maritime, into healthcare, into all these areas and make things much more better. So that you don't have a Jamtara or different types of, you know, places coming up.
Jamtara rods.
So these small, small places which have come up, the villages, they have made millions also.
Their backend is like politics and all that.
Not just politics, it is money. At the end of the day, it is money. Who cares about politics? They didn't care about politics when they started making money. They made money and the politicians came over there.
Okay, yeah, support.
The politicians are already there in the area. Then one fine day the politicians realized that, okay, these boys are making money. You come and give me something, other than tell the police to come and catch you. So then both of them started doing things together.
So what advice you will be giving to the public about cybersecurity?
Advice for cybersecurity.
See, a lot of scams nowadays happening. Okay, so people are getting video calls on
Facebook. Use common sense.
Use
common sense. Nobody uses common sense. You got a WhatsApp mail, phone call. I can show you, I have it on my phone. This is about 2-4-5 days back. Inspector Kishan something. His phone number is +92 something.
Okay.
His name is Inspector. Is it the spelling of Inspector? INSPECTOR. I just deleted his phone. Why should I answer? The only people, my sisters live in America and Canada.
Mm.
I have their numbers. If they call, they are my contact list. If somebody else calls from the US, I don't have any business over there. I just delete the phone.
Mm. Nowadays, a lot of boys facing the problem, like they are getting a video call, nude video calls and all. They are attending and then they are...
Why?
They are getting into that trap.
No. You don't know somebody.
Mm.
Why are you answering the call?
They're discolite about this.
No, there are pornographic sites. Go to the pornographic site, pay money and then do.
Mm.
Then view over there. Nah. You get live shows, this and that, everything. Here, somebody called you.
Mm.
The papers, the newspaper is full of, the media is full of news every day.
Mm.
Somebody or the other being cheated of lakhs of rupees because of this sort of scam. WhatsApp call,
screen recording and they're asking for money.
Correct? Why? And if somebody asks you also, tell them go and do it.
What precaution they have? Once what action they have to take after if they
gone says I don't know you, why should I answer your phone?
No, after they done the mistake, what step they have to take?
Just keep quiet. Go to the police.
Mm.
If today, supposing you are cheating, you are blackmailing me and saying you are going to release my nude photographs, I say, do it.
Mm.
Go. Go and do it. There are 1 billion people on the internet.
Mm.
Are you so famous? And if somebody sees it, okay, how many people will see it?
Mm.
See, in today and today, supposing he sees it, everybody in office sees your nude photograph. If I see your pictures, I know. If somebody made my deep fake here.
If you get fear, miss, then they get
why?
Chance.
Dalo. And if somebody like that same parcel FedEx scam and all that, or even the romance scam. Now that romance scam, see, becomes very sad in the sense that some lady or some guy who's been wanting or who's alone or whatever, you know, gets trapped by somebody in the love affair or whatever, and then that guy says that one parcel has been sent to you, and then got the customs call and all that. That is sad.
Then again this one, the loans one, 5,000 loan they are giving, then they
are sad
texting to their everyone in their contacts.
Yeah, I know, but that is a sad thing. Very difficult.
So how these companies are surviving, you know, like doing this all activities, and how these companies running that?
Why people take the 5,000 rupee loan or 1,000 rupee loan? You don't know how desperate that person is. I can't pass judgment and say this is a solution for that. The solution is very simple. It is just to try and be away. I can only say that.
Mm.
And why I say that is because I have been through very, very difficult times and I didn't have money at all. And if somebody would, I also wanted 5,000, 10,000 rupees.
Mm-hmm.
And there was nobody in this country, people don't give me money like that.
But running this type of company, loan company, there should be proper permissions from RBI and all.
There should be so many proper things here.
Yeah, but why in this
company? There are so many chit funds that are running in this South India.
Yeah, yeah.
Correct?
Local chit funds.
You have grown up in South India, all of you.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
You know that.
You've seen chit funds have been.
But that is not publicly disclosed. But what? Nowadays, chit funds and all.
Who says it is not publicly disclosed? There are so many people who have lost their lives because of chit funds.
Mm.
Chit fund collecting money and then being bankrupt or running away.
Yeah, the same thing is happening now online. Same thing,
yeah.
But in online. Yeah.
So here, this is a different thing where you are taking a 5,000 rupee loan from somebody and that guy says, put this APK on your phone.
Mm.
You will do whatever. He says, I need 5,000 rupees, you have to give me a phone and that's it. My APK will put all your contacts and put everything.
Yes.
Right? Now, even if you have paid my 5,000 rupees to me back, I will still do all that shit.
Because contacts, as we save the contact, so it will be sending to all. So, with the best way is like, you won't have to go with unknown
applications
and all.
The best way is to try and, you know, face up to the problem which you have. I only say that.
Mm.
I can, like I said, I have been through so a couple of times in my life when I had a problem for 1,000 or 5,000 rupees also.
Mm.
No, those times were such, I could go to a bank, and ask for money, but the bank will say, what do you have for collateral? I don't have a house to show them or this or that. Mm-hmm. I have nothing. So you give me some FD, I don't have FD. If I had FD, I would have broken the FD and taken the money from there. So I want to get payment from my suppliers, but my payment will come out at 20 till 30, I want the money tomorrow. Mm-hmm. What do I do? I still remember there was a time when I needed money the day my dad died. He was in Delhi, I was in Bombay. So me and my family, my sisters and my mother, we have fried them. We don't have money. 9:30, 10 o'clock in the night, 8 to 9 in the night, we came to home. Then we are running around to my friends, college friends and this friends, my sister's friends, collecting money. What do you do? If at that time, if these loans were there, I would also put the loan, the easiest way, but I make use the application, get a loan, mm-hmm. go attend the funeral, come back, and then get screwed by the loan company. Mm-hmm. So you don't know, and that's where neither me nor the government, nobody in this world can give a solution that when Mahesh needs 1,000 rupees life and death situation, You don't know what sort of circumstances you will be in. The only thing which you can do at that time is sit quietly, pray, and think rationally. What is my solution? What can I do? If I do this, if I do this, if I do this. One or two solutions at the most. Don't ask you for advice. You will never get good advice. And it's a very dangerous situation. I only pray people don't get into that situation. There's no other solution. Social engineering, romance scam, and those things, again, no solution. Except your own mind. How rational you are at that time, how you face up to the situation. But don't allow common sense to get away. Take up, like old times, paper and pen. So the problem. Solution, solution, solution. Three solutions. There can never be more than there can be only one solution. There can't be three. Mm. But scenario 1, 2, 3. And then quietly decide, well, this is what I have to do. What are the pros and cons? What do? It'll kill you. If I have taken loan from you, old times, Dao and gangster loan, it'll kill you. Huh? Mm. Nowadays, the loan company, they kill you literally. By sending the pictures to all your digital model.
Digital.
That time it was actual model. They'll take you, bash you up.
So as a solution is like common sense. You have to use the common sense to come out with this problem.
Use common sense quietly, maybe you go to the temple, sit in the corner. Take a pen and paper, sit over there quietly.
Be away with your phone for a few days. This is also a good solution. And don't get into depression and all for this thing.
No, you don't get into depression. Trust me, that's yes. It's not easy to say you don't get into depression. You will get into depression. Mm. We are human beings here. Yeah. All these things affect us, and we can't. There's not just one single solution for that.
So, how can businesses can implement the cybersecurity into their daily operations?
Businesses have to be proactive to understand that IT is not the only solution. When IT comes to you, it comes with other responsibilities. Security is another responsibility. So don't think security is a separate thing only. People think that security is totally different. It has got nothing to do with technology. That is what they forget. And people bring IT solutions for security. Again, they forget that there is a security requirement over there also. So if I buy an SIEM or a DLP or something, I have to configure it to be effective. It is a security solution, but I don't do that. I'm buying technology, I'm buying IT, CRM solution, and cloud services, server, VM, this, that, or whatever. But when I'm buying all that for technology, for providing services to the company, from business services, I must make sure that I make it secure. It is not just there's people do what they'll buy the technology, okay, we will do this later on. Right now we don't have time. Right now we have to get it running. Wrong.
So is that for every industry into this business?
Every
cybersecurity.
Everywhere, even your phone.
Mm.
When you buy your phone,
mm.
buy the antivirus item itself.
Mm.
You're spending 1 lakh rupees, 2 lakh rupees for a phone.
Mm.
You're not spending 100 rupees for antivirus. Why? Well, very expensive.
Mm. Like you are making crores of money and not investing lakhs like for
no,
the
crores.
Nah.
You went to buy the latest iPhone for 120,000 rupees. Peace. Is that sir, you want to put antivirus for 200 rupees? No, no, no. 119 is good. 200 rupees I don't want to spend. It's too expensive. I'll get it back complete.
Mm.
That is the problem.
Things will change.
Hopefully.
So what do you suggest to other businesses about cybersecurity?
No, I would say this. At least read about what it is there.
Mm.
Don't think it is technology.
Mm.
It's about good practices. Good practice means not technology. Draw a straight line and see.
So we'll wind up here. Yeah, so it was nice talking with you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So thanks for coming and giving these good talks and with us. Okay. I hope you guys will like it. So yeah, do subscribe and stay tuned update for next podcast with Coffee with Hackers.